Okay, welcome to the Hampden Town Council meeting for January 17th, 2017. Could you please join me for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Next item on the agenda tonight is the consent agenda. Does anybody have any questions on the consent agenda?
Move to adopt a consent agenda.
Second.
Further discussion? All in favor? All opposed? Thank you. The next item on the agenda tonight is public comments, and at this time, if there is anything that is not on the agenda tonight, this is the chance for the public to speak. Do we have any public comments? Seeing none, we'll move on. We have no news presentation and awards tonight. The next item on the agenda is the public hearings. Consideration of the proposal repeal of the Town of Hampden Conservation Ordinance. Should be committee here, shouldn't it?
Ordinance.
Oh, okay, the ordinance. So with that, I'd say the public hearing is open. Do we have any public comments? Would you please come up to the podium, push the button so the green light's on, and give your name and address, please?
Okay, my name is Mark McCullough, and I'm a resident of Hampden. I live at 25 Griffin Avenue. So I wanted to speak tonight. I just found out yesterday about this motion to end the Conservation Commission. And I was on the Conservation Commission when it last met. And I can't remember the date, but it's been a number of years ago. So I wanted to reflect on that. It actually surprises me quite a bit that the town would consider stopping this important committee, because we did a lot of really good work, and we provided hundreds, if not thousands, of hours of donated volunteer time to the town on a number of different kinds of projects. So if you weren't familiar with the Conservation Commission, here are some of the things. I served on the commission for at least 7 or 8 years. I think we had 2 or 3 year terms, and I did several successive terms. Some of the things that we did to provide a service to the town, we provided or helped the town develop an inventory of the open space that the town owns, from creating various subdivisions. And we help provide you folks, the council and the planning board, with advice on open space issues. So when new developments were built in Hampden, we would help provide advice. Is this piece of open space worthy of protection? If not, you know, we would provide ideas as to what might be a better solution. So we provided a lot of input to the planning board over the years on subdivisions, and that was one of our roles. Another thing that we did towards the end of the committee is that we helped gather a lot of information for the town's comprehensive plan. We had a couple of our members that worked for the State Fish and Wildlife Agency, and we helped the GIS expert here in the town to develop a lot of different data layers on wetlands and streams and wildlife habitats, and all of that made its way into the comp plan. We were also charged during the time I was on the committee by the council to develop an ordinance. So when you mentioned earlier, it's both a committee and it's there's an ordinance, I believe, that helps define the roles of the Conservation Committee. Another thing that we were asked to do by the town council is to help develop a policy for the fish warden on Sadabskook Stream. We consulted with a lot of different towns in the area that do alewife harvests, and developed a policy for that. And I believe the council advertised a position for the fish warden, but no one ever applied. But we're very interested in that resource. That's a really important natural resource that the town has, is that alewife run, both as a natural resource and potentially an economic resource to the town as well. So we brought in a lot of fisheries biologists from the state, from DMR, from Inland Fisheries and Wildlife to help develop that policy. Other things that we used to do is we had an annual tree planting every year. The town had a small budget for the Conservation Commission, and we used to plant trees on open spaces that the town owned. We also played a role in helping to get the Tree City USA off the ground here in the town of Hampden. And that was separate from the Conservation Commission in the end, but we helped to get some of the grants and so forth to help that make that happen. We sent representatives every year to the annual meeting of conservation commissions in the state of Maine. Many, many other towns have conservation commissions, so I can't imagine why the town of Hampden would want to no longer have one. Another project that we worked on for quite a few months was developing a trail inventory of the town and working with our GIS staff here at the town office to map some of the town's trails, snowmobile trails, hiking trails, access areas to certain bodies of water and so forth for people who like to fish and recreate and boat. So that was a big effort that we did. We worked with the public works people here in the town office to help with recycling out at the transfer station. We helped provide advice to public works on different markets for recycled goods. We always spent a couple days each year out at the transfer station. We'd go out for the whole day on a Saturday, and we'd provide information. We developed a brochure on recycling in Hampden to try to promote recycling. It actually saves the town a lot of money to recycle. And we would go out and talk with town residents who came out on the weekend to the transfer station and distribute brochures and try to promote recycling out there to save the town money. We worked a lot down at the Dorothea Dix Park to clear trails and maintain trails down in that area. We also participated in the Greater Bangor Area Hazardous Waste Day. So people that have hazardous waste, like unused ammunition, toxic waste that you just can't take out to the transfer station. Bangor promoted a hazardous waste day every October, and we would send several people from the Conservation Commission to go and help with that. And we would advertise it on the town website and promote that within the town to get people to use that. We helped almost every year with over at the high school with the Hampden Envirothon. That's a group of students who has a competition every year on environmental type activities, and they do a special project every year, and it would always be focused here in Hampden, and we would often provide input and help to the students to do that. So for instance, one year the students developed a concept to look at a sort of a green corridor along Saldabscook Stream. Another year they looked at water quality issues with Sucker Brook down towards Bangor. And so we would help the students with those projects. We also were involved with some water quality monitoring on Saldabscook Stream with one of our residents here in Hampden, Cassie Gibbs, who was on the Conservation Commission. And we would also help organize and participate in the annual stream cleanup day, often down by the marina along the river to clean up garbage along the river bank. We had minutes of all of our meetings, and I'm sure they're in the records of the town office if you're interested in looking at some of the things that we used to do. We develop minutes of every one of our monthly meetings, and we produced an annual report for the town report every year. So I feel all of these things were really beneficial to the town. You might ask, well, what happened to the Conservation Commission? I really don't know, you know, what your rationale is for ending the commission. But my recollection, being on the commission when it ended, or last met, it never really officially ended, is there were some controversies related to the comprehensive plan you're all aware of a number of years ago. And at that time, I think we had one or two of our members who participated on a committee to help work through some compromises related to the comprehensive plan. But right at that same time, the town played a role in organizing and calling the meetings of the committee, and it just simply stopped. There were no meetings called from that point forward, and those of us on the committee who were serving 2 and 3 year terms, I guess we just eventually became termed out of the committee. But it was always a mystery to some of us as to why we just stopped meeting at that time, because as you can see, we were quite active and provided a lot of services to the town of Hampden. So thank you for allowing me to speak.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Does anybody have any questions for him while he's right there, or unless you have an objection?
To the best of your knowledge, when was the last year that you had a meeting?
Well, it would be the year that there was as we were finishing the comprehensive plan. So I'm thinking maybe 5-6 years ago. And many of you probably recall that because it was quite contentious. And that coincided with our last meeting. It was about that time.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Green button is pushed. Good evening, Mr. Mayor and Council. My name is Ed Stelzer. I live on Manning Mill Road, and I've lived there since 1979. We went through a lot of changes over the years, obviously, with the shoreland zoning, protected resource zones. It got me interested in what was going on, so I joined the Conservation Commission through Hampden. I served for about 8 years. My last term as chair ended in 2009. Mark did a wonderful job, you know, giving you an idea of some of the programs we did. We had 6 members on our committee, and most of them were professional, either environmentally, state employees, others that just had a vast knowledge of what was going on in the community. So I can't, you know, restate everything he did, obviously, for the sake of time. But one thing that's important to remember is there was a man named Charles H. Duell. I don't know if you're familiar with him. But Mr. Duell was a commissioner of the U.S. Patent Office, and in 1899, he said, "Everything that can be invented has been invented." I don't want to see us in the same situation. We still have a lot to do in conservation. So I urge you not to repeal this ordinance. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any questions? Great. Thanks.
I'm Bill Lippincott. I live on 30 Wilbur Drive. I've just been listening to Mark and all the beneficial things that this commission has been doing over the years, and I really think it would be a shame to lose that for our town. As I hear it, it had a function, and then the town stopped calling for their advice, but it seems to me they had some very useful things to contribute to the town. So I would like to speak for, I'm against the repeal of the ordinance. I think this town does need guidance as there are pressures of development that will continue. There are open spaces in the town, but we want to preserve our clean water in the town. We want to do what's right for the town, and that will really enhance the desirability to live in our town. And so again, I'd just like to urge that we not repeal this ordinance. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else like to speak? Seeing none. Discussion?
Yeah. I don't think that the council was actually getting rid of anything here. We actually made an effort earlier, or late last year and early this year, to try to reinvigorate this conservation committee, and we didn't have anybody coming forward that wanted to be a part of the committee. The committee hasn't met the best of my knowledge, since 2012. And while they did serve a great purpose with the town and probably could serve a great purpose with the town, the committee doesn't exist. The only thing that we were doing was repealing the ordinance that outlined everything for the committee, because the committee has no, or the townspeople appear not to have any interest in having the committee continue. You know, if we're wrong about that, I don't know how we could see that we're wrong. We could be. We did reach out. We did try to get the committee back up and running, but we didn't have any responses except for two people, and they withdrew their names. If there is an interest from the community, I'd be all for keeping it on the books if the committee would get back together. But I don't see a reason for the ordinance to be on the books if the committee doesn't have any committee. That's all I've got.
Any other comments? Councilor Marble?
I think, at least this is my interpretation, the simple background on this is the council and town manager have invested, and other staff, have invested a lot of time and effort in reviewing ordinances, reviewing the guidance on the books that dictates what we do. There have been healthy agendas on this council about trying to make processes simpler, about making it easier for housing developers and homeowners or small businesses to do business in Hampden. So we had a reputation, and well earned in some cases, that this was not a friendly place to do business in. So as you see on the agenda, and if you've seen any other committee meetings, a lot of work, for example, has gone into things like the sewer ordinance, which sometimes grinds exceedingly heavy and dull when you're in the trenches doing that kind of work. In this case, again, in my interpretation, my feeling, the sense was, if we can make the guidance of the town simpler, and we, as Councilor Wilde just mentioned, don't have an active commission, then why do we have an ordinance on the books that's supposedly guiding what we do when we don't, in fact, have a reality that mirrors that ordinance? I spoke at committee level, and I will say again tonight that my concern is in the messaging. There were comments in committee that, well, if there's a time in the future when it seems to be more of a need or more people are stepping up to be active with the commission again, we can just reconstitute the ordinance. Personally, that doesn't send a message about the town that's one I admire. I think that we're in a town that has access to at least two waterways that have been mentioned, the Sowetapscook and the Penobscot. I think environmental awareness is at a higher level in general in society than it was 20 years ago. And we have a lot of professional citizens in this town who care about things like the environment. And I think that we ought to keep the ordinance on the books to welcome more citizen re-engagement in the process and advice. We're trying to monitor the Pine Tree landfill, as Bill Lippincott has cited here in chambers a couple times. And collectively, we're at least an average intelligent group. But when you get into technical reports and citations, it's not always the easiest thing for a counselor to sit back and have great confidence in their own interpretation of what they're reading. I think that's a place where something like a conservation commission could play a very helpful role. So I'm speaking to not repeal the ordinance, to keep it in place for the reasons I just mentioned.
Anybody else? I guess the only thing I would like to say is, you know, they have done a lot of great things in the past, as was told to us before. But I would also like the town to realize that since that committee has been dissolved and hasn't done anything, the town has done a lot for the Paper Mill Park. They've done a lot for Dorothea Dix Park. They've done a lot of good things. We've had a lot of stormwater now, so we have to monitor Sucker Brook. There's a lot of good things that the town is still participating in for good conservation. for this town. So I don't want people to think that just because that committee's gone and we're talking about doing away with a conservation ordinance, which is tied into the committee, that this council and some of the past councils has still been looking to the best interest for the town of Hampden. We all live here, and we probably all have the same viewpoints that you people do, that we're really trying to do the best thing for the town. Now, in future cases, if something comes up and, you know, we're trying to build something over here that's going to, you know, affect the Sourdough Stream, I hope you and 1,000 other people come in here and say, no, you're absolutely wrong. But at this point in time, I feel that the prior council and the council that's here right now has a lot of interest in preserving a lot of the natural resources and taking care of the town of Hampden. We've all been here a long time, and we all want to be here. So I don't want people to think that, you know, we're dropping the ball on something and nothing's being done, because that's not the case. Any other comments? Do we have any other public comments before we get into a vote? See this gentleman come in late. I didn't know whether you had something you wanted to say.
I might have questions,
though. Okay, that's all right. You can come right up here and go ahead.
Sorry, I don't have a whole lot of back knowledge on this. I've only been here a couple of years. So.
It's okay.
Do I give my name? Or
give your name and address, please.
Bill Boyington, 95 Main Road North.
And make sure that green light's on. Push that button right
push
on,
this?
On the mic.
It's on.
Okay, you're good
okay.
to go.
I just have a few questions. One is, how often do you repeal ordinances? Is it pretty common, or is this sort of a unique instance? Or, I mean, you amend them, I'm assuming, but to repeal them fully, is that?
We've done.
Again, question, and if you don't have the answer, that's fine. I was just curious.
I'll just take a crack at this. Oh,
okay.
Angus Jennings, town manager. The as Councilor Marble had alluded to, I began work here in August of last year, and part of what I did in getting a lay of the land was looking at all of the ordinances, policies, regulations the town had put in place over time, and where I found instances of a mismatch between what the ordinance said and what was actually happening, I would bring it to the council's attention. And this is just that type of example where, and I will say it was one of many, where the ordinances say there's a harbor committee, the ordinances say there's a tree board, not anymore, but they did. The ordinances say there's a conservation commission. At the time I started, we didn't have a single member of the historical commission. We're now up to a full quorum on historical commission. We've made a lot of outreach, both through newsletters, social media, word of mouth, on trying to engage additional volunteer committee members. And over the course of the last 16 or 17 months, we've had some success in some areas getting more people involved, getting up to quorum. This is one, as was noted, there has not been interest expressed. As the this was put onto the agenda this fall with the Services Committee, and Councillor McVoy was chair at the time, and I know there was some concern expressed by the committee about certain aspects of the ordinance that created, for instance, requirements of town-wide plans, not just for town-owned forestry, but also for privately owned forest land. So there were, I think, questions of the appropriate role of government in terms of this ordinance. And because there was no commission, there were no members appointed, I think, you know, the direction was to repeal it. And as Councilor Marble and I believe others have said, was said during the Services Committee, if the time comes when there's need, when there's interested people, I know at least some members of the council support that. But from where I sit, I see, you know, a good example actually is the Environmental Trust. That's a committee, had not met since 2009. We have reconstituted that committee. They are now meeting, and they actually have resources, funding, that they oversee and can actually do some things. So that's an area where we've put some real effort to shore up what was not there. But, you know, there's far more that was, you know, we have to be strategic about where we put in time, and we have gotten a lot done. We are getting a lot done, but there are certain things that we can't do everything. And so when the
I just
committee did ask, you know, about staff impact of if this commission was to be restored, what type of staff impact would that have on what staff, and that was part of the discussion at committee, and I think they felt that those personnel are fully allocated on other matters at this point.
Back to my question, I'm just curious, when was the last time you fully repealed an ordinance? So that was that question. So, and I understand what you're saying, and I understand why you're saying
it. We just did the tree ordinance.
Do I still have more
time? We just repealed one within 3 months, a month ago.
Okay, great. I was, my next question, I think you already answered it, was just what would serve in its place as something that provides an additional oversight other than just let's wait until we see something outrageous and then generate 1,000 people to come down and be upset about it as the course of action. So I did read the plan prior to coming here, so I had a little bit of knowledge, and it seems to me that the commission was set up really pretty outrageously for anybody to participate. I think it required 7 people from a small town with sort of a cutting edge kind of mindset of governance, and I'm not saying I'm in favor of having that. To me, it looked like maybe it was a little too intrusive and they had a little too much authority too soon, but perhaps maybe we should consider at least amending it and maybe looking at trying to trim it back. That was only what my thoughts were, but you know, I'm curious to know more about the environmental trust and what those roles are and those powers are, so that we do have some sort of oversight other than just, like you said, when we see something bad, come down and complain. There's somebody that has a mindset towards that and a little bit of funding towards environmental review other than just traditional planning reviews. So that's all. So thank you. You answered my questions.
Thank you.
All right, thanks.
Any other discussion?
I just have a question. Has there been any other inquiries as far as the Conservation Committee since the last time we met and discussed this interest in board, interest in serving as a board member?
No.
Well, I guess I'll ask these gentlemen out here, is there an interest in serving on the Conservation Committee? Because
Steve, just a minute, let's let this gentleman speak.
Hi, my name's Doug Poulin. I'm live at 55 Ruth Avenue. My question is, what is the harm in leaving the audience, leaving the ordinance as it is? Why does it have to be repealed? Is there any harm in it?
Well, I think some of the rules and guidelines in there, I think, were some of the issues why we wanted to do away with. One was the timber harvest was not just town, it was private owned land and everything else. So I think that was one of the deciding factors. If there's no committee, why do we need a rule in there telling private landowners what they got to do with their property? So I agree with the gentleman that just spoke that I'm all for conservation. Maybe this whole thing needs to be amended and a lot of stuff deleted and got rid of. But it still gets us back to the same point. We don't have anybody that's interested in being on the committee. So it'll just sit there and do nothing. Councilor Soros.
A lot of the conversation tonight I agree with, and I think totally repealing the ordinance, I think, is taking an axe probably where we need to go in and trim. We can do it with a scalpel or have conversations around reducing or even reducing the number of people on the committee itself to a more manageable number, and we can get the people we need on board. So I think Councilor Marble hit it right on the head. I just think doing away with it totally is probably too much.
Any other discussion? Do I have a motion?
I make a motion that Town Council repeal the conservation ordinance.
I second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor? All those opposed? 4-3. Thank you. The next item under public hearings is a consideration of the proposed amendments to the Town of Hampden Sewer Ordinance. That was referred by the council on January 4th. Basically, the sewer ordinance is a verbiage issue where there was a lot of wording changed in the ordinance. It didn't have anything to do with rates. It was strictly just details on how it was written. Do we have any public comments? Seeing none, do we have any discussion? Councilor Marble?
Again, for public benefit, I would just like to take the opportunity again regarding this ordinance in particular to cite the work done not only by the council and committee over time, but mostly with town staff, including Department of Public Works Director Sean Currier. This is a lot of work.
Further discussion? Do I have a motion?
I'd move that we accept the amendments to the Hampden Town of Hampden Sewer Ordinance.
Second.
All in favor? All opposed? Thank you. Next item tonight is nomination, appointments, and elections. 3A, appointment of James Dyer to the Recreation Committee, referral from services. Councilor Marble?
This is where you're going to expect I remember again, right? No, it was our pleasure at services to accept the application of Mr. Dyer to the Rec Committee. I don't see him here this evening. But he came with an interest, history in the town, and a lot of qualifications. So I would recommend the appointment of Mr. Dyer to the Rec Committee.
Second.
Any public comments? Discussion? All those in favor? All those opposed? Thank you. The next item is the appointment of Jason Sharp to the Recreation Committee. Referral from services. Council Marble?
Yeah, and no, I won't go there. This is on public record. Jason Sharp would be a reappointment, I believe. And he's been currently acting as the chair of that committee. So we appreciate his service. And again, it's a recommendation from services to accept the appointment of Jason Sharp to the Recreation Committee.
Wholeheartedly seconded.
Any public comments? Discussion? All in favor? All opposed? Thank you. Next item is under new business. Item A, notification of an unanticipated invoice for the annual video streaming service in the amount of $2,370 and the review of recommended budget adjustment out of overlay for the purpose of Laytronics cost. Referral from finance. Councilor Wilde.
Yes, this was discussed in finance earlier tonight of an unanticipated invoice for video streaming service in the amount of $2,370. We did recommend that we move it up here to council. Definitely approve it. Thanks.
Any public comment?
If I might.
Yep.
I just add, for informational purposes for those watching from home, that Laytronics technology is what allows the video that's or the TV that's available for, through local cable to be pushed out through the internet so people can access it on computers and mobile devices. The reason the amount was not budgeted is we got the first year free because of enticement that was offered, and that predated a number of staff, so that institutional memory had been lost. And so that the reason this was recommended as a budget adjustment is so that the allocation actually comes out of the appropriate line item, so as we look at FY18 budgeting, we have an accurate picture of true costs.
Thank you.
Important to note also that in future budgets, this will be a line item that will be included.
Public comments? Do I have a motion?
I'd move that we spend the amount of $2,370 out of the overlay for the purpose of funding Electronics costs.
Second.
Further discussion? All those in favor? All those opposed? Next item under new business is a request for authorization for the expenditure of $1,462.50 out of library reserve funds for the purpose of squirrel trapping and exclusion. Referral from Services and Finance.
This started in Services to review the situation with an invasion of squirrels in the library, which was dealt with. The funding to cover that is coming out of reserve, and we recommended in Services that it go to the Finance Committee, which it did tonight.
Councilor Wild.
And in the Finance Committee, we had another brief discussion about this, and it is something that had to be taken care of rather quickly. So we did move this up to the council for authorization of the expenditure of $1,462.50 out of the library reserve funds. Briefly discussed the possibility of including that in the operating line budget for future budgets.
Thank you. Public comment? Seeing none, do I have a motion?
I move we authorize the amount of $1,462.50 from the library reserve funds for the purpose of squirrel trapping and exclusion.
I second that.
Discussion? All in favor? All opposed? Thank you. The next item is request for council ratification for the September 30th, 2015 expenditure of $3,345.46 from the police cruiser reserve account. Referral from Finance. Councilor Wild.
This one was a little bit more complex, but in budgets past, it was my understanding that we had put in to the tune of $15,000, sometimes $17,000 annually through the annual budget, in order to move that forward from budget year in order to purchase police cruisers. Now the current practice is to have that in the reserve funds going forward, but in the past we overlooked a budget a vote approving an expenditure of $3,345.46 from the police cruiser reserve account to purchase a police cruiser. This is simply a matter of good housekeeping and going back and ratifying this particular expenditure, which we did discuss back then but did not take a vote on. Thank you.
And just to add to Councilor Wild's description, the council did vote in December of 2015 to authorize the purchase, but it only covered up to $30,000, so it's that margin of the $3,345.46.
Any public comment? Seeing none, do I have a motion?
I move we authorize the expenditure of $3,345.46 from the police cruiser reserve account.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor? All opposed? Thank you. The next item is 5D, request for authorization for the expenditure of $7,388 out of the IT reserve for the purpose of upgrading surveillance system for the municipal building. Finance Committee, Councilor Wild.
This came to us tonight from the IT department, and we do have a dire need to upgrade some of the cameras in our a surveillance system here at the town office and in the police department. The price tag seems a little bit high, but keep in mind these are high-depth cameras, I believe, that have a lot better quality, and the system right now is antiquated and not working optimally for us. Also, good to note that the reserve fund for the IT department is in excess of $60,000 at this point, and we haven't had to put a lot of money into it. So the request for the authorization of the expenditure of $7,388 was moved up to council for consideration.
Thank you. Public comment? Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion that we approve the authorization for the expenditure of $7,388 out of the IT reserve for the purpose of upgrading the surveillance system for the municipal building.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Discussion? All those in favor? All those opposed? Thank you. The next item tonight is committee reports. Services Committee, Councilor Marble.
Services Committee met on Monday the 9th, and much of what was on the agenda has already been reported out tonight in various ways. In addition to those... Mic on, even though I'm yelling. In addition to the items that have been already brought up tonight, we had an update on the topographic survey of the pool site. I would encourage the general public to simply keep in mind that work is progressing and a DEP permit will be involved. If you have any questions, please call the town office or speak to a counselor. We had an update on items from a January 5th Rec Committee meeting, including an impact statement on the recent minimum wage increase that was approved by referendum on the town's recreation department. And the short version of that is town staff and the rec department director are finding creative ways to operate the rest of this fiscal year as is, basically, by not filling a position that's vacant and matters like that. But this will require a budget adjustment or a reduction in services, which I don't think will be recommended, to make this work for next year and the following. I'm looking to Jason Sharp in the audience. 2 years? Two additional years? Can't remember. Is the minimum wage program a three-year program?
It's 2020, so 2010,
11, 12. Okay. Issues and information regarding the Community Connector and Hampden Bus Service continue. We have not been receiving any good news in terms of future costs. There is at question the matter of towns annually setting aside money in a capital account towards eventual bus replacement on schedules. And I don't believe either Hampden or a couple of the other towns served by the bus have been doing that. So that's going to make discussions about challenges in the budget more so this year. There are ongoing meetings. I believe the town manager and I and maybe another counselor are going to attend the next one, I think at the end of next week or the week after. And again, we will keep everybody informed as best we can on this issue. And unless I've omitted something else big, I think we've about covered it.
Thank you. Finance, Councilor Royal.
Most of the items we discussed at our last meeting, which was just previous to the council meeting, we have talked about here at the council meeting. It included the annual video streaming expenditure, expenditure for squirrel trapping, expenditure or ratification of an expenditure for the police cruiser, and then the update of the IT or surveillance system for the IT department. In addition to that, we did talk briefly about some of the upcoming budget proposals on a state level, and the fact that it may be prudent of us to reach out to our state representatives and also RSU 22 to see if we could get a meeting together to address these things and our concerns sooner rather than later. In addition to that, we also had a tentative date of February 11th, I believe.
18th.
February 18th at 8 a.m. That's on a Saturday here in the town office, and then we'll be starting our finance and our budget preparation proceedings at that time. Thank you.
Thank you. Planning and Development, Councilor McPike.
Planning and Development met on Wednesday, January 4th. There was an update on the MRC Fiberite direction that's going. Major discussion on that was concerning Hampden Water District and where the water line coming out Colebrook Road, what is taking place with that. It is between the Water District and MRC. There is a meeting on the 19th at 4 o'clock, which is the Hampden Water District's board meeting. A lot of this will be discussed, and I believe that meeting is going to take place here because of the fact that there may be a turnout of number of people on this, and we're suggesting that anyone who is interested in this, that please attend that meeting. We talked about dangerous buildings. There are some buildings that were dangerous, are not dangerous now, but have some, I should say, problems in their appearance perhaps, but we don't have any rules or regulations on appearance. We're starting to tread lightly when we go into what a person's home should look like. it was brought up at that meeting that perhaps one of the things we could look at is taking TIF funds, putting them into a low-interest loan, or perhaps a loan guarantee program, and that owners of these properties may have the opportunity to come in and borrow at a low rate or a guarantee and be able to fix these properties up and get them back on the market or in useful state. We also talked about zoning considerations. Part of the major thought process that took place was the marijuana referendum that was passed. It was determined by the committee at that time, by a show of hands, that we do not need to delay anything, that we stepped forward and we took a vote, that we would have the planner start with a policy, and that policy would be anything that was as a medical marijuana establishment. We did not want switched over to retail marijuana, so we went with the fact that we prohibit all or some of the uses and have zoning ready for the state has started a license issue, and that we would have retail stores and social clubs would be prohibited. All others we would include. That would be cultivation facilities, product manufacturing facilities, or testing facilities. It's in the very, very beginning stages. Of course, the state still has a lot of work to do on it, but we thought we would take our step first and have our stuff ready to go. And then when the time comes and the state gets done with theirs, that we would put the policy, present that to council and present it out to the public for their feelings on it. And that was basically all we talked about.
Thank you. Infrastructure?
There has not been a meeting since the last meeting. Your next meeting is scheduled for January 30th.
Thank you. Next is the town manager's report. Town manager Jennings.
I have just a handful of brief updates for the council and for the public. One is a grant application was submitted earlier today to DEP for $95,000 grant to help us with the culvert on Old County Road. So we had, I think, a very strong submittal, and we'll keep you posted on how that turns out. But if that funding comes forward, that would directly offset a cost that would otherwise be borne by the general fund. As was mentioned earlier, we're moving toward setting up a meeting with the Augusta delegation, and as part of that, we will look to partner with RSU 22 so we can talk about issues of common concern. I do have a meeting with Superintendent Lyons this Thursday to talk about a number of issues, and we'll include that in that discussion. I wanted to let people know the Children's Day Committee is starting to ramp up and is actively looking for volunteers. So if people are interested in supporting the preparation for Children's Day, you can either contact us at the town office or the rec director, or contact Janet Hughes directly, but that will take a lot of work over the next 6 to 7 months. Transfer station stickers. If you haven't purchased your 2017 sticker, those need to be on your vehicle no later than February 1st. There is a 1 month grace period where 2016 stickers will be seen as current, but as of February 1st, they will draw a hard line. So if you don't have that sticker, be sure to get it. I wanted to just update briefly on the Environmental Trust. We're working on getting another meeting set, and as you may recall, part of the work that's going into that is looking at expenditures that the town has made out of the host community benefit account since 2009, which was the last date that the Environmental Trust met. So I've been going through those expenditures of the last 7 years, identifying those that would be eligible for payment out of the trust, and I'm working toward presenting that to the trust with the goal of getting some funding coming back into the host community benefit account. And it's nearly $270,000 worth of expenditures over that roughly 8-year period. So that's my report.
Thank you. The next item tonight is councilor comments. Councilor McAvoy.
Thank you, Mayor Ryder. I just want to remind everybody to shop local and buy American. Good night, Hampden.
Councilor Cormier.
No comment.
Councilor Marble.
I want to thank the members of the public who wrote and came out in person tonight to talk about the Conservation Commission ordinance. The council vote did not go the way many in the audience would have liked it to go. Nevertheless, the discussion was healthy. I think we all learned some things, and it's an issue that can be revisited in the future, whether that's short or long term. My own feeling is that this is a better town and a better council when we're clearly aware that members of the public are connected to what we're doing, care, and care about the town. So thank you again for people are getting involved.
Councilor Wilde.
No comment.
Councilor McPike.
No comment.
Councilor Sirois.
No comment.
The only comment I have tonight, it is nice to see the public show up, get involved, and tell us their feelings. We need to know that. And I know from listening to people, sometimes they think it's a waste of time to come here to a council meeting. It's all cut and dried before they get here. And I understand their view, but I urge each individual, if you have feelings on any topic, that if you can come to a committee meeting, it's not publicized, it's taped, but you can get in a room one-on-one and have a good, healthy discussion with the council on a different level before any decisions ever come to this table. So I think it would be a good opportunity for the public to get involved on that level. And that's my only comment for tonight. Do I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
Thank you and good night, Hampden.